Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is risen. And Jesus is still on the throne. Precious one, it is written in Genesis chapter 21 verse 1 that the Lord visited Sarah as he has said, and the Lord did unto Sarah what he has spoken concerning Sarah. In verse 2 of Genesis chapter 21, he says that for Sarah conceived and bore Abraham a son in his old age at the set time of which God has spoken to him. God is about to give you a very powerful and a very favorable visitation. And the visitation of the Lord will bring conception into your life. The visitation of the Lord will bring fertility, fruitfulness into your life. The visitation of the Lord will delete every reproach over your life. And the visitation of the Lord will put laughter and dancing into your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, get ready for that visitation in Jesus' precious name. Amen. On this note, I want to welcome you specially to Rising with Jesus. This is the program the Lord has designed to work wonders in your life and to give you advanced victory as never before and to make you more intimate with Him in Jesus' precious name. I want you to know that the Lord is gracious unto you. The Lord is thinking of you. The Lord is thoughtful about you. And the Lord will always speak in your favor and He will not turn against you. I want you to lift your voice and appreciate God for the backing He has given you, for the assistance and the support He has given you. I want you to lift your voice and appreciate God for all the benefits He has loaded you with. In the name of Jesus, shall we lift our voice and bless the name of the Lord? Father, we worship you. Father, we honor you. Father, we adore you. Father, we enthrone you. Father, we give you all praise and all adoration. Receive all the glory. Receive all the praise. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we magnify your name as never before because you have been a faithful God unto us. You have never failed us. You have never disappointed us. Whatever you have spoken concerning us, you have stood by it. And so, Lord, you did not allow the plots and the intentions of the enemy to prosper against us, but your will and your counsel has prevailed and has stood in our lives. You have lifted your hands against the assault and the onslaught of the adversary. Father, we appreciate you for your favorable intervention, for your mercy and your grace that is at work in our lives. Receive all the glory and receive all the praise in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Precious one, very soon we will be entering into a time of prayer, and I want to share something briefly with you to stir your faith and to prepare you for the prayer time. I want to talk to you briefly on what I have entitled The Power of Growth. The Power of Growth. It is very, very important for us to grow. Anything that does not grow is not acceptable. Once you are a living organism, you must grow. Growth is an indication that you are alive. Growth is an indication that you are not dead. Death is the enemy of growth, and death is the terminator of growth. Once you are not growing, it means that there is no life. It means there is no life. Once you are not growing, it means there is a question mark about you. So you must grow as a person. You must grow in wisdom. You must grow in knowledge. You must grow in faith. You must grow in spirit. You don't only grow physically. And so when there is no growth, it means you are dead. That is why you need to be born again. You need new birth. Once you experience new birth, it is a guarantee for your growth in life. Another thing you need for growth is feeding. You have to eat. Without feeding, there can be no growth. So you have to feed on the things that facilitate your growth. These are some of the things we are going to be looking at. The next thing you need for growth is health. You need to be healthy to experience growth. That means that you must fight against sicknesses and diseases. Once sicknesses and diseases and infirmities prevail against you, your growth will be undermined. Your growth will be stunted, or your growth will be terminated. And so you need life, you need feeding, proper feeding, and you need health to be able to grow. One of the meaning of growth is that you become larger. You become larger or you become bigger. It is growth. When growth is there, it causes you to grow larger. Without growth, what happens is that you diminish or you decline. Without growth, you will drop or you will go down. So growth ensures that you are amplified. Growth brings development into your life, and growth causes you to abound. Growth is a necessity. You cannot afford not to grow. Look at your life, check your life, check your business, and check whether growth is taking place. Growth is a prerequisite. Growth is a must. You must grow. You must not accept the situation in your life where you are not seeing growth. In Genesis chapter 48 and verse 16, Genesis 48 verse 16, the Bible says that let them grow into a multitude in the midst of the earth. And so once you are in the midst of the earth, once you are part of the earth, you have no excuse for not growing. It says that let them grow into a multitude. You see, growth is what brings about a multitude. Growth leads into multitude. When you begin to grow, you have influence over multitude. You don't have influence over only few, but you have influence over multitude. Everything that is positive, anything that is acceptable that you must do, you must employ or deploy to grow, you must make sure you deploy it. It's very, very important. In 2 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 5, 2 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 5, the Bible says that when they told it unto David, he sent to meet them because the men were greatly ashamed. And the king said unto them, tarry at Jericho until your beards be grown, and then return. He said, tarry until your beards be grown. You see, growth is very, very important, but growth will not come without waiting. Growth will not come without tarrying. You need patience. You need to be able to tarry. You need to be able to wait in order to experience growth. Because when a farmer plants his seeds, when a farmer sows his seeds, he needs to exercise patience before he can see growth. That is how your life is. If you don't have patience, you will not be able to wait for your growth. You will destroy your seed, you will destroy your investment, and you will destroy your effort. So patience and tarrying and waiting are vital prerequisites for growth. Anybody that is not ready to wait, anybody that is not ready to exercise patience will abort and terminate his growth. But I pray for you in the name of Jesus that your growth shall not be aborted. In the name of Jesus, I declare that every spirit of impatience that is working against you will be removed in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Growth is shame remover. David said to them in 2 Samuel chapter 10 verse 5, the Bible said the people were greatly ashamed. But David said, wait until your beards are grown. That is the only way the shame can be removed. Many of us, our lives are characterized by all kinds of shame. Our lives are being overshadowed by happenings and occurrences of shame. But if you can tarry, if you can wait and wait well on the Lord, what will happen is that the growth will take place and the shame shall become history and the glory shall become your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. I release that glory into your life in Jesus' name, and I command that shame to be dismissed from your life in the name of Jesus Christ. In Ezra chapter 4 and verse 22, the Bible says that take heed now that you fail not to do this. Why should damage grow to the head of the kings? Why should damage grow to the head of the kings? I pray for you in Jesus' name that damage will not grow against you. Damage will be destroyed from your life. Damage will be dispelled from your life. Every force that has been sent into your life to cause damage to grow against you, I command that force to be broken. I command that force to be neutralized. In the name of Jesus, I pray that repair and restoration shall manifest in a grand style in and over your life in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want you to know that it doesn't matter where you are located, growth is a possibility. Growth is a possibility. In Job chapter 8 verse 19, the Bible says that out of the earth shall others grow. Out of the earth shall others grow. There is room for others to grow. Some might have taken the lead in growth, but there is room for others to also grow. I pray for you that you will be among the others that will also experience growth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If others have taken the lead in growth, it doesn't mean that you will not also grow. I assure you by the word of the Lord that your season of growth is now. Your season of growth is come. Get ready for a takeoff. Get ready for speedy growth in the mighty name of Jesus. What are you doing? What are you engaged in? I want you to know that your time to grow has come, and the baptism of growth is coming upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In Psalm 92 and verse 12, the Bible says that the righteous shall flourish like the palm tree, and he shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Righteousness is a growth stimulator. Unrighteousness is a growth terminator. Righteousness is a growth stimulator. Unrighteousness is a growth terminator. When you go for righteousness, your growth is guaranteed. So when you walk in righteousness, it enhances your growth prospects. I encourage you in the name of the Lord Jesus to uphold the force of righteousness. I encourage you in the name of Jesus to hold on to the nature of righteousness. I pray for you in Jesus' name that every whispering, every suggestion that is calling you to throw away your righteousness shall be silenced from your life in the name of Jesus. I pray that you not only grow, but you flourish and you do well in the name of Jesus Christ. In Psalm 104 verse 14, it is written that he causes the grass to grow, that the grass may bring forth. He causes the grass to grow that he may bring forth. Growth leads to a bringing forth. Once you start growing, you experience a bringing forth. Once you start growing, you experience fruitfulness. Once you start growing, that issue of abortion in your life shall become history. I pray for you in Jesus' name that your business will bring forth. I pray for you in Jesus' name that your wife will bring forth. I pray for you in Jesus' name that your finances will bring forth. I pray for you in Jesus' name that your career will bring forth. In the name of Jesus, I break the forces of abortion that aborts your fertility and your fruitfulness in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In Jeremiah chapter 12 and verse 2, the word of the Lord says that thou hast planted them. Yea, they have taken root. They grow. Yea, they bring forth. Jeremiah chapter 12 verse 2, it says that thou hast planted them. Yea, they have taken root. They grow. Yea, they bring forth. And so one of the things that will lead to growth is that you have to be planted. You have to be planted. Don't be running here and there. Don't be running helter-skelter. You have to be planted, because there is a proverb that says that when you urinate at one place, it bubbles. It leads to bubbling. It generates bubbles. That means effectiveness. Effectiveness and potency is enhanced when you learn to focus and concentrate on one thing and in one place. And so the Bible says that you have planted them and they have taken root, and so they are growing. You see, if you are a Christian, you must have a spiritual house. You must have a church where you are planted. You must have a spiritual family where you are planted. You must belong somewhere. If you are not planted, you have not taken root. If you are not planted, you will not grow. And so I pray for you in the name of Jesus that the grace of God to cause you to be planted shall be released upon you in the name of Jesus. Everyone the enemy has sent into your life to uproot you from your place of growth, to uproot you from your place of flourishing, I declare them removed from your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you that your location of greatness, you shall not be uprooted from that place. Your location that will cause you you to expand and experience influence. You shall not be uprooted. You shall not be removed from that place. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, in Jeremiah chapter 33 and verse 15, Jeremiah chapter 33 and verse 15, the Bible says that in those days and at that time will I cause the branch of righteousness to grow up unto David, and he should execute judgment and righteousness in the land. He said, in those days and at that time will I cause the branch of righteousness to grow up unto David. So righteousness, as I've said earlier on, is a growth effector. It's a growth facilitator. Don't throw away righteousness. As you uphold righteousness, as you embrace righteousness, your growth shall be enhanced in the name of Jesus. Unrighteousness is the enemy of your growth. Don't settle with unrighteousness. Settle with righteousness in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In Daniel chapter 4 and verse 22, the Bible says that it is the king that has grown and has become strong, and for your greatness is grown and reaches unto heaven, and thy dominion to the end of the earth. One of the things growth does is that growth strengthens. Growth strengthens. If you are really growing, you realize that you have become strong. Growth strengthens. When proper growth is not taking place, weakness will take over. Weakness will set in. Once you are growing spiritually, what happens is that you become spiritually strong. When spiritually you are becoming weaker and weaker, it means that you are not growing. So you must grow, and you must take into consideration the factors of growth that we have talked about. Growth will enhance your greatness, and growth will deepen your dominion. Growth will enhance your greatness, and growth will deepen your dominion. The more you grow in spirit, the more you dominate. Once you grow in knowledge, once you grow in wisdom, once you grow in spirit, your dominion cannot be disputable. Your dominion shall be established in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. There is something about growth that I want to read to you right now. In Matthew chapter 13 and verse 32. Matthew chapter 13 and verse 32. The Bible says that indeed this seed is the least of all seeds, but when it is grown, it becomes the greatest. It is the least of all seeds, but when it is grown, it becomes the greatest. You may be called the least as we speak. You may see yourself as the least, but all you need is that you have to be given the chance to grow. You have to be given the chance to grow. Somebody who is the smallest, somebody who is the insignificant, can also grow. I want you to know that insignificant business, that insignificant status, that insignificant position, just allow yourself some time. Once it begins to grow, your greatness will emerge. It says that when it grows, it becomes the greatest. Your greatness is connected to your growth. Your greatness is connected to your growth. And so you must ensure that you are experiencing growth. You must put in place the practical steps we have talked about so that your growth will come and your greatness will manifest. If you don't grow, you cannot become great. Greatness is not automatic. If you don't grow, you cannot become great. So we have said that you have to grow. You have to feed in order to grow. Anybody that gives birth to a child is not thinking twice whether the child will grow or not. Once you give birth to a child, you know that the child will grow. So growth is automatic once there is life. Growth is automatic once birth has taken place. But you have to prevent the organism from sicknesses and disease. You have to feed the child. You have to make sure the child is healthy before growth can take place. What is making you unhealthy? Check the health of your life. Check the health of your spirit. Check the health of your business. If your business is not healthy, if your life is not healthy, your growth shall be undermined. So work on the things that makes you healthy. The word of God, the Bible says it is medicine. Once you embrace the word of God, what you are doing is that you are taking medication. The word of God is a medication. Anytime you receive the word of God, you are receiving medicine. And this medicine will make you healthy. And that is what will lead to your growth. And that is what will provoke your greatness. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In Matthew 21 verse 19, the Bible says that when he came to the tree, he found that there was nothing on the tree but except leaves. And he said unto it, let no fruit grow on thee henceforth forever. And presently the fig tree withered away. Let not fruit grow on thee henceforth forever. And presently the fig tree withered away. Jesus came to a tree and he didn't find anything on the tree. One of the things that helps you to grow is that you must be fruitful. You must bear fruit. If you are not productive, there is no way you will grow. And when you are not growing, you attract a curse. This particular tree was not able to bear fruit. This particular tree was unfruitful. And because the tree was unfruitful, it attracted a curse. In this life, make sure you are growing. Make sure you are growing. Once you are not growing, you become a location for curses. Curses are attracted to lives that do not grow. Curses are attracted to lives that do not flourish. Once you begin to grow, curses become alien to you. Growth detests curses. Growth repels curses. Growth attracts blessings. I admonish you to go for growth. I pray for you in the name of Jesus that a new hunger for growth shall come upon you. A new desire for growth shall come upon you. You will not be satisfied with the status quo. You will not settle for your level, but you will always be driving for another level of growth. I pray that that grace shall come upon you right now in the name of Jesus. I am telling you today that that business will grow. I am telling you today that that small business will grow in the name of Jesus. Whatever you have started, I want you to know that whatever you are engaging in is not your last stop. The growth is coming. Just follow the things and the ingredients I've provided you with, and you will experience sweatless growth. Receive sweatless growth. Receive speedy growth. Receive accelerated growth in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want to pray with you right now. You have to be born again. You have to be born again. Until you are born again, you will not see growth. New birth leads to growth. And so wherever you are watching me from, please pray this prayer with me right now. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I come to you as I am. Forgive me for your name's sake. Wash me with your precious blood. Come into my heart. Be my Lord and my Savior. And let my life be a testimony to all those who know me. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for answered prayer. Amen. Precious one, you are now a child of God. I want you to lift your voice and bless the name of the Lord for this message you have heard right now. I know something has been sparked positively in your life. Lift your voice and thank God for this timely message. Lift your voice and bless the name of the Lord for this timely message. Lift your voice and glorify Him in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for the viewers that the process to their growth have been initiated in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you so much. Yes, Lord, that they are on the path of growth. I bless you that their eyes are open. I bless you that their faith is lifted. I bless you that they have started a new race to a new level. In the name of Jesus, I give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen. You are going to pray that every enemy of your growth will be broken and will be bound. In the name of Jesus, you are declaring that, my Father, let every enemy of my growth, financial growth, material growth, marital growth, career growth, every enemy to my growth be bound and be arrested in Jesus' name. Lift your voice and pray. We bind and arrest the enemies of your growth in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been spoken from any quarters, whatever has been planted from any quarters in any location to fight your growth and to subdue your growth, we bind and arrest them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We declare that the enemies of your growth will not proceed further. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Matose te remo zoka, leba de baba sota, limoko sakata kalibre zende, malio bro zegele baladoste, araba da baba sota lo maso, mota kalibre zegele balado saya. Libo takalia brazo. Melege zegele brazota. Areba deba basataya. Malakataka luzate. Aroba daba bazada. Mbolodo saya. Karoba daba basota. Melige sekete kaluandaya. Aroba deka basata ramazadaya. Malagaba satalia brazande. Enemies of their growth. I command you to cease in your operations, in their lives, in the name of Jesus. Braze kaloso. Mbolodo se. Mikata karasataya. Melede zete. Molodosa, arabada babaso talo mokosa, karobade babasa tea, malada baswa, arabade kamoso, molodosaya, karasa kataka lia brazande, melege zeke lia brazotaya, militu saka, rando basaka lia brazaka lia brande, I release into your life growth assisters, I release into your life growth supporters. In the name of Jesus, I release into your life the forces that will back your growth, that will facilitate your growth. In the name of Jesus, Braso Talime Kese, Meledo Zandaya, Rando Basaka Lio Brazete, Melege Zegelia Brazwataya, Malataka Swaka, Lozota Rozegele Beledea, Maziko Lota, Leba Deba Bazadara Mazadaya, Moko Sakalibre Zegele Baladaya. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you want to pray also and declare that you power of failure, you power of frustration, you power of backwardness, expire from my life in Jesus' name. You power of failure, you power of frustration, you power of backwardness, expire from my life in Jesus' name. Lift your voice and make that declaration. Lift your voice and pray right now in the name of Jesus. Powers of failure, expire from their lives. Powers of frustration, expire from their lives. Powers of backwardness, expire from their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Braze Kalo Zande, Mekete Kali Brazande Rambo Zande, Malagaba Sakata Kalia Brazande, Molota Kalia Brazande. Powers that will provoke favorable results, we release unto your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Makataka Librea, forces of focus is released into your life in Jesus' name. Brazata, forces of progress and acceleration is released into your life in the name of Jesus. Brezekele Madusa, Malada Baswaka, Likoto Kalosa, Aroba Deba Basetea, Braya Balandosa, Reba De Kambosa, Malada Baswata, Liko Matosaya, Balido Zete, Rando Mokosa, Kaluata Kalibre Zegele Baladosa, Molodose, Meba Beta Kaluta Romosa, Melege Zwa Kalibre Zegele Beledea, Arosi Kolio Brazagala Baladaya, in the name of Jesus Christ, Mita Kaswaka, Randaba Shataya, E Mate Kalibra Sataya. Let growth visit these dear ones, these dear viewers, wherever they turn. Let the grace of growth embrace them. In the name of Jesus Christ, Muto Sehe, Lando Romo Zeke Lemo Zete, Muzako Liobro Zete, Mite Kelete, Rando Baso Kaliobra Zea, Malada Babasataya. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Finally, you want to pray that you desert arrow fired into my destiny, expire in Jesus' name. You desert arrow fired into my destiny, expire in Jesus' name. Lift your voice and pray. You desert arrow fired against my destiny, expire in Jesus' name. I speak for you right now in Jesus' name. Every arrow that has been fired to make your life a desert, to make your business a desert, yes, to make your destiny a desert, I command them to expire in the name of Jesus Christ. Brazagalo Zede, Randaba Sakata Kaluande, Robo Zagala Baladea. I command them to expire in the name of Jesus Christ. Rando ba zagala baladea. Karoba do zeteya. Melege zegele beledea. Karoba de baba zade. Melege zegele baladaya. Aro sakalia brazande. I command them to expire in the name of Jesus. Brazagala baladaya. Rato sakaya. Melede zete. Mologo zaga. Randaba saka. Lando seke lebre balando ze, malakata kaliobro zegele beledea, Karo sakalia brazade, molodo sataya, malaga zagala baladaya, aro sakalibre zegelebeledeya, brazo kalo sataya, maladaba sataya, desert arrow, aspire from their lives, desert arrows, aspire from their lives, desert arrows, aspire from their lives, in the name of Jesus Christ, brazagala baladaya, aro sekelebelede zede, malato sata rembede zeya. Melige zegele baladosa, arosa calabrea balandosa, reba dosa te remosa gora mosa taya, malataba sacaliebre zege, mologo zo calusaya. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Father, for the answer to prayer. Lift your voice and appreciate God for the answer to prayer. Bless the name of God for answered prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, receive all the praise, receive all the glory. You are a faithful God. You never turn back our prayer. You never refuse our prayer. Thank you that instant answers are released. I bless you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. I want to pray with you. You are sick in any part of your body, or you are believing God for any breakthrough. I want you to lay your hand where you are hurting right now. Stretch forth the other hand to the screen as I pray with you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, thank you for these dear viewers. I send your healing power to wherever they are, and I take authority over the forces of sicknesses and diseases, the forces of weakness and infirmities, forces of oppression released against them. I command you to be bound in Jesus' name. Come out of their lives. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I speak healing from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command your expectations to be released. I command your breakthroughs to manifest as never before. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I command favor to pursue you and overtake you. In the name of Jesus, I declare that you see positive results in whatever you are doing. In Jesus' precious name, I call it done. Amen. Precious one, before I go, I